far than anyone in Jerusalem before me. In all this, my wisdom stayed with me. I denied myself for nothing my eyes desired. I refused my heart no pleasure. My heart took delight in all my work, and this was the reward for all my labor. Yet when I surveyed all that my hands had done, and what I had toiled to achieve, everything was meaningless, a chasing after the wind. Nothing was gained under the sun. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray responsibly, Psalm 49, by half verse. Hear this, all ye peoples.
Thank you. Glory to you, O Christ.
Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide the inheritance with me." But he said to him, "Man, who made me a judge or arbitrator over you?" And he said to them, "Take care and be on your guard against all covetousness. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions." And he told them a parable, saying, "The land of a rich man produced plentifully." And he thought to himself, "What shall I do? For I have nowhere to store my crops." And he said, "I will do this. I will tear down my barns and build larger ones. And there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, 'Soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, and be merry.' But God said to him, 'Fool, this night your soul is required of you, and the things you have prepared, whose will they be?' So was the one who lays up treasures for himself and is not rich towards God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Some of them are, "It is written, man Therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat, what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more important than food, and the body more than clothing? Matthew 6:25-34. Jesus continued to tell the crowd a story about a foolish rich man. Listen as I read the story again. After he realizes how much grain he has, and hear how many times the man uses the first person pronoun. What shall I do? For I have nowhere to store my crops. And he said, I will do this. I will tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I will store all my grain, all my goods. I will say to my soul, so you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, and be merry. This man was very self-centered, but he had a surprise awaiting him. That night, God told the man that a soul was going to be required of him. This man lost sight how fragile his life was. Ours are just as fragile. The man never thought about his own mortality and was about to lose it that night. Like in the story of the five foolish virgins who were not ready for the bridegroom when they were locked out of the wedding feast. They were not prepared. The rich man thought his life was going to go on and on. And every day he thought about what would happen to his soul after he died. Have you ever thought about your souls after you die? Each one of us in this church building is going to die. The rich man never gave a thought of looking to God for guidance as to what he should do and with all his grain and wealth. He only asked himself what he should do. He never thought about his future. Just the present of eating, drinking, and being merry. Never once thought about storing up treasure in heaven. He had no concern for the poor as a good Jew was supposed to. He just kept thinking about himself and all that he possessed. He soon was going to find out he was wrong. Very wrong. God told him that night his soul was going to be required of him. We have no idea when our souls will be required of us. This man was not rich towards God. You may wonder what being rich towards God means. Here are some ways to start. One, we should be thankful for the many blessings God has given us. When we go to bed at night and say our prayers, we should give thanks to God for the blessings of that day. Two, be a good stewardship. That means returning to God a portion of what he has given us. Three, we should be generous towards our neighbor. Jesus told us to love our neighbor. As I've mentioned on several occasions, our neighbor is not the person next door, but the person we meet in the store, on the sidewalk, and other places. Jesus said in Luke 10:27, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. Jesus is not telling us we can't have hobbies and collect items such as coins, stamps, or fishing letters, and so forth. I myself enjoy putting together my HOLA and have collected a lot of stuff over many years. But we should not let our collection drive us from our Christian obligations to our neighbors for building up treasure in heaven. The rich man in today's gospel reminded me of a TV show Guy and I watched some time ago. I think it was called Hoarders. Man had so much stuff he accumulated over the years. He was a retired college professor and had a good retirement. He was single and his house was so full of stuff he could barely walk in. The stuff was mostly
two cars in the driveway that were stuffed. Plus piles on the driveway were covered with a blue tarp. He lived in a homeowners association and was being fined for not cleaning up his yard. His son decided to step in and contract with the company to clean out the house and yard. The father agreed, but he wanted to inspect each and every item that was going to be tossed. Needless to say, things got off to a very slow start. It took a long time, plus several 2,000-pound capacity dumpsters full, to clear the gardens away. Mind you, he did not get rid of everything. His dining room was clear, his bedroom was clear, and he could walk through the house safely. He had so much stuff he could never use. Sadly, he never thought of getting up to the Salvation Army, where they could have helped those in need. Today's rich man could have helped feed the hungry in his community. If he were a good Jew, he would have been expected to help his neighbors. Jesus warns us in the Gospels about being greedy, also known as avarice, which is the desire to possess more than we need or can use. Some people buy things just so they someone else can have them. Today's Gospel of Jesus warns us about greed and possessing more than we need. Madison Avenue does its best to get us to buy things, whether they are needed or not. Paul tells us in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 9 through 10, that those who desire to be rich fall into temptation, into a snare, the many senseless and harmful desires that plunge people into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. It is through this craving that some have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many pains. I want to close with a story about the needy king and a sage. A sage was passing through the capital city of a famous king. While he was walking, he noticed a single coin on the road. He picked it up. He was satisfied with his sense of living and had no need for the coin. So he planned to donate it to someone who had need for it. He strolled along the streets throughout the day, but did not find anyone who needed it. Finally, he reached a rest area and spent the night there. After his daily morning activities, he sees that a king is going through a forced invasion of another state with his war-ready army. When the king saw the sage coming and standing there, he ordered his army to be stopped. He came to the sage and said, "Oh, great sage, I am going to war to another state so that my state can be expanded. So bless me to be victorious." After thinking, the sage gave his single coin to the king. The king was confused because he was already one of the richest kings. He curiously asked the sage, "What is the meaning of this one coin?" The sage explained, "Oh, great king, I found this coin yesterday while strolling the streets in your capital city. I had no use of it, so I decided that I will donate it to someone who is needy. I strolled around until the evening in your capital, but found no one who was needy. Everyone was living a happy life. It seemed that they were satisfied with what they had. So I found no one to give this coin. But today, the king of this state still has a desire for more and not satisfied with what he already has. So I felt you were needy with this coin." The king realized the mistake and gave up the planned war. The moral of this story is, we all should learn to be happy with what we have. Yes, we still all desire more and better than we already have, but do not waste the chances of enjoying what you already have. There are those who may not have what you have, and there will be some who have lots more than you have. Do not compare, be happy, and lead a healthy life. Now to God, the Father, God, the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit, be ascribed as most justly due all might, majesty, power and glory.
Let us pray for the church and for the world, saying, hear our prayer. For the peace of the whole world and for the well-being and unity of the people of God, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our bishop and our bishop and for all clergy and people of our diocese and congregation, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all those who proclaim the gospel at home and abroad, and for all who teach and disciple others, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters in Christ who are persecuted for their faith, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our nation, for those in authority, and for all in public office, especially our President, President Biden, Lord, in your mercy, in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any adversity, especially
God. We confess
shall do the laboring of a laborer, and I will give your rest. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. The saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. Ascribe to the Lord the honor of doing his name, bring offerings and come into his courts with prayers and thanksgiving.
Amen. do not deserve